but I want you to feel that weightlessness,
okay,
if you will, along with, we'll call this kill shot. Turn it sideways, baby.
So just weightless kill shot.
A weightless kill shot. There's our new phrase. I mean, it don't get no better. We talking med ball, son.
All right.
Number one, got to throw Kendal Yonomoto into this. Kendal is a mentor of mine. I would really recommend a lot of folks purchasing his ebook. It's a great ebook.
I'll put it in the video description so people can look at it.
Perfect. That's excellent. But Kendall's absolutely phenomenal. And one of the main reasons that I love Kendal so much is that he makes things dynamic. Mm-hmm. Right, and a lot of these medicine ball throw exercises that we're about ready to explain and show feel great, and you immediately get the athletic translation
yes.
to swinging a stick around,
mm-hmm.
which is great, rather than, again, put it here.
Yeah.
Doesn't work as well.
Right.
First, let's just show a couple of throws. I'll stand over here, and you can
sure.
just huck it at me. Don't throw it too hard. I'm fragile.
Okay.
But throw one of the basic ones. Good. Now, as you're doing this, just explain a bit on what you're feeling.
All right, so kind of two separate systems here. The arms are kind of doing their thing. They sling up
okay.
the midlines while the chest is rotating.
Yep.
Okay. So arms are swinging up. As I'm rotating, I'm going to let this ball fall underneath me. Okay, as I'm doing so, you kind of see that kind of drop in the pelvis, sinking into the ground as it reaches under my center of gravity here.
Yep.
I turn back through with it, arms climb up the midline again.
Perfect, perfect. And just for basic anatomical terms, this action right here, this is called shoulder flexion, this
okay.
is shoulder extension.
Got it.
So when TJ's talking about lifting the arms, that's a shoulder flexion action.
Got it.
And again, he's talking about the arm swinging up the midline.
Mm.
Now, do they move exactly up the midline in the golf swing? Not quite.
Sure.
Because as I turn, my midline now is on this look right here.
Mm-hmm.
So the arms don't swing on this action.
Sure. Fair enough.
But just to like notice and see in space, right? This is a vertical action. It's just like the hands are going straight up.
Yep.
Vertical.
Mm-hmm.
So if I turn over here and I let my arms swing straight up vertical.
Fair enough.
That's what the hand path does is it swings
swing.
Up.
Yep.
Now the club head is on a different curve,
mm-hmm.
and we show some internal action, and there's some stuff that goes on in the wrist, and so the club head itself and the shaft might look a little bit different.
Okay.
But as far as training what the hands do,
mm-hmm.
really, really cool look. And notice again, like go ahead and set up Tej. TJ lets the ball hang underneath him. For a lot of players, they'll hold it out here for whatever friggin' reason. That's not it. Say the arms aren't hanging,
mm-mm.
you want dead weight underneath.
Yeah.
And a really cool exercise too, Tej, go ahead and face the camera now. Okay, and what I want you to do is just move the rib system laterally and let the arms just follow the rib system. There you go. And instead of as much bend, just show more lateral movement in the ribs. There you go. See how much more the ball moves? So the ball is almost moving in response to the rib system.
Got it.
Than shoving the arms around.
Sure.
So TJ isn't shoving the arms back here.
Nope.
To do that, see how now the ball is off my midline?
Yep.
Yep, exactly. So that's lead arm adduction, blah, 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 blah.
Got it.
Right? So we're moving it. See that? Ugh. The arms are responsive to the ribs. So to sling the arms up, you're almost going rib sling. There you go. Exactly. Ooh, that's cool. And you can see, like in that action, the heaviness of the ball. It like mm-hmm. floats up here. And starts to fall back over the other way.
Yep.
And as it falls, then you start to learn now as it once it starts to fall, I can respond to
yes.
shoot it off the other way.
Yeah, instead of like probably a common bugaboo would be that.
Yep.
Right.
So if you do that with something that heavy, you're just gonna throw it in the ground.
Yeah, it ain't gonna feel very good either.
No, it's not. Whoosh, there you go. Go ahead and toss a couple more to me.
Okay.
Beautiful. The other cool thing, like as TJ does this, you'll be able to notice it. The ball does not spin and it comes out at the same level that he starts. See, and it's hit me in the knees.
Mm-hmm.
That's because it's about where he's starting here.
Got
so
it.
It's not like throw one up here. Way more extension to get that up here.
Interesting. Okay.
Yep. So you can do variables on this. So if I wanted to throw one and bounce pass to you.
Got it.
Okay, this would be low because it's just going to skid. Okay. But now to do that, I'm going to stay like in more hip flexion to be able to do that. Because, yeah, look. See how your ribs like they respond forward to shoot it down.
So that could be like flighting it down. Right? Would be a little bit of a bounce pass here.
Yep, exactly. What a great way to do it. See how you stay in hip flexion for longer, dual hip flexion. That's a great way to do it.
So like a common one that you might see is this spin on the ball through impact, right? And that would come more or less, from that extension pattern.
Yep.
And the natural kind of hand motion from there is a little.
Exactly. So show a bad one.
Okay.
Lots of extension, lots of throw, so much spin. Yep. Exactly. And that's a high balloony floaty cut or a big old dart hook.
or
you
dart hook.
Guessed okay.
Sometimes you can guess okay. Yes.
Flash it
on. Leave that out.
Yep, exactly. But even starting with this, like this is a good angle to see this. I'll do it right at you, Teej.
Sure.
So I'm going up, catch it. Now if I just turned over here and toss it, now I can feel the arm swing again up the midline on the other side. So they're up here. And that looks really similar to what a golf swing would be.
So you could kind of teach yourself this drop and swivel action first.
Yep.
And then go from there.
And then just toss. Yep, exactly.
Okay.
And you could even fake it out to where I'm going, okay, drop, turn, and my midline's over here, arms swing up, see how the ball didn't spin at all. If I just stood and let the arms fold over, that's the finish position.
Got it.
So there's so many variables that you can teach yourself in these fun little actions.
Uh-huh.
Okay. One of the ones that you just talked about was drop.
Yes.
Okay. Drop. So let me see the ball actually. So if I've got the ball up here, swing, drop. As it's dropping, if I want it to drop more or for longer, I fall with it.
You fall. Okay.
So if I'm dropping with it, see now I'm dropping with like it's way less. Now I caught it. So instead of just, it's not weightless for long right here, weightless. That is dual hip flexion to drop. So like you'll see my rump work away and down.
Yes.
And that's the gather, as Kendall would talk about. But for us, it's the preservation of time in transition. So P3 to P5, that's when you're going to start to drop. You'll see our favorite athletes start to drop in that phase. So even as the golf club's finishing its action up to the top, they're going to be dropping during that phase. Yes. So if TJ had the ball, it'd be dropping as he's going into flexion of the hips. Yep,
got
and
it.
You can do that in a lot of ways. So if I'm in here and I'm going turn, now get the arms kind of putting energy into the ball as it goes up. Now I can fall with it. And notice how I'm like tossing it, like letting it actually go. So I'm letting the weight of gravity or the momentum of gravity go. So I can just learn, I can drop in here. Once I drop, I think Kendall calls it the heavy point. As I drop and catch it, this would be the heavy point again. That's when I know I can toss it to the other side.
But not until you reach the heavy point, right? If you're really trying to train this.
Yep. And what's important with the heavy point is if I've got it here and it's dropping, dropping heavy point, that's not impact.
No.
It's like P6, P5, P6, somewhere in here. So now as I start to go sacrum and turn, boom, there's impact and through impact.
Got it. And that's why I like to build on a previous concept. Once you drop here, that's the heavy point. This lead shoulder working up, back and away, clears all the room for this club to shoot out.
And shoots it out. Yep. So show that one. We call this pump.
Okay.
Okay. So show two pumps. And then once you feel that heavy point, then you can just turn and toss it at me. So you're up. Pump. Now we could toss. There you go. So now you start to feel this like boom, boom, boom.
So you're tossing after the heavy point.
Yep, exactly. If you wanted to do it even better to preserve even more time.
Interesting. So that's kind of, I'm not going to lie, that's like I've played around with this feel with a golf club in my hand a bunch recently.
Yep.
It feels like you're tossing it up, waiting for it, catching it, and going.
Hit one.
It really feels like that.
Yeah. I mean, obviously, you're not going to toss it with a darn golf club, But let's feel the same amount of energy. Yep. It's so good. It's so good. It's awesome because, yeah. And you see it like really, I mean, it almost looks overdone.
Sure.
But honestly, it looks so good because you have so much time in here.
Yeah.
To organize, yeah. See ya. And that one still had, what amount of energy on it do you feel like? If that's 100% cap, where were you at?
60, somewhere
and
around there.
To be honest, a ball is going to go probably at least 90% of whatever full is.
Yeah,
right. Like that was 8-iron?
Super efficient.
Yeah, so we're in Colorado, so 8-iron goes 900
forever,
yards.
But yeah.
But like typically 8-iron's like what, 165, 175?
Somewhere around there, yeah.
So like let's call it 170. If it goes 90% of it, you're in like the 150, 155 range. Uh-huh. I guarantee that ball went at least that.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Right.
Yeah.
So it's not actually 60%. It feels like you're working 60%.
No, that's an important thing. Like it feels like you're not working very hard.
Exactly, but that's efficiency. Our preferred pattern is such a late hit.
Yep, agreed.
That, okay, give us time from P3 to P5. I don't want to. I want to get it back here. Because I need this. Everybody knows that this needs to get back onto the golf ball.
To the ball.
So
yeah.
I need it down here. Mm-hmm. I need it down. Okay. Well, that's an arm action hit pattern.
Got it.
Okay. Whereas our preferred pattern is, it's on my right side. I'm just going to turn to get it into the ball.
Mm.
Boom. So this already is late because it's like, it should be on the ball. It's not on the ball. Oh, whoop. There it went. Now it's on the ball.
Yeah.
Rather than got it on the ball.
Yeah.
So there's like two things that we're battling. That rotational hit mechanism.
Okay.
Okay. And number two, from up here, we're just dropping and not doing anything with it. Yeah.
No, there's nothing that needs to happen.
So it's
right
like
there.
Floaty. So this takes time already. Uh-huh. Floaty. And then once it gets in delivery, wait even longer.
Yeah. It feels like everything happens. Like nothing's happening. There's everything.
Yeah, and then even then, it's like, okay.
Yeah.
It's like,
yeah.
You never want me to hit it? Exactly. That's exactly what we're
talking
about.
Pretty much, right?
Compared to the old pattern of like, fire this down. Yeah, this is like, hit. Now.
Yeah.
Get it back on the ball. Again, is there one way to skin a cat?
No, definitely not.
Multiple different ways to do it. And what we're talking about right now, like, there's a couple of kids down in Arizona that we've actually talked to in our full-time academy about, you need to actively feel lead arm adduction, active, and lead shoulder extension. Boom!
Yes.
Get it down here. Mm-hmm. Because they've just overcooked, drop, turn, the arms never do anything. This is unhittable as well.
Yeah.
How are you going to get it on?
Like,
yeah.
Not much good
this
is going
to
happen.
This needs to be down at some point.
Right. So there are a few different ways that you can do that according to what you need to feel personally in your pattern.
Based on everybody's individual system.
Got it.
But 95 out of 100 people, we see too much of this.
Doesn't mean that those five don't exist, right?
But, exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly. So, yeah, it's just knowing the matchups. Again, that's why we like talking in systems. Just
sure.
A systems approach is going to help so, so much. So we talk a lot about, I even hate this term now because everybody hates it, shallowing.
Okay, got it.
It's not necessarily shallowing. It's just getting the golf club in a position at the end of the load phase, which is P5. So this from P1 to P5 is all a load phase. Mm-hmm. Positioning the golf club into an area and the forces that I'm putting on it that strain the golf club, strain my fascial line, strain muscles, so that loads. It's like I'm expanding that whole system to a point now that when I rotate, it wants to shoot the golf club out because of angular force.
So that's the whole point, is feeling this fully stretched out load into delivery.
Yep.
Right.
And the reason that, stupid term, shallowing happens, okay, set up again, is because where the center mass of the club or the balance point of the club, it rides up on top in the backswing and then it moves over here, and we need the instrument to move over here because it stresses the instrument, stresses the body, so that now I'm loaded as a mug. So if I just let this go, TJ start turning, go. It just shoots it out.
So that's the whole point.
So we're like, it is allowed to go this way because as I rotate this way, boom, it's just like, it stresses the whole system for longer.
Got it. So when the club is stressed behind in this fashion, generally as you're rotating the chest, it just wants to sling into the ball.
That's angular force.
Of
and
its
that's
own
a
accord.
Stable pattern. Angular happens because of rotation in the chest, the club's back here, and it shoots out.
Now let's contrast that maybe to a load pattern that happens a little early, mm-hmm. right in the backswing. And now that's the
exactly
snap.
Yeah. Yeah, so what TJ's talking about is if we go back to setup generally,
okay,
and we go up here anywhere, like let's say the club's swung up on top of it,
okay,
but if TJ puts energy in the arms down, so it's that shoulder extension,
yeah,
that leaks to the humerus, mm-hmm. working in external rotation, so now the club, the center mass of the club is working outside.
Mm-hmm.
So this is the active, like, look of rotating this, see how close it is and outside the line it is.
Mm-hmm.
So if you just kept going, it'd be kind of a way to release the club, but you're gonna feel like, for most systems, you're gonna feel like you work really hard and get nothing out of it because you're never stressing systems at all.
Sure.
And to create room, the arms are going down, so I've got to create room by going up.
Understood, yep.
This extension pattern, hip extension leaks into spine extension. These are anti-rotational movements.
Got it.
That make the golf club now flash.
Okay.
Are there guys out there that do that?
Sure. Yes.
Vijay Singh does that. Mm-hmm. Phil Mickelson does that. They're really good players.
Great players.
Right?
Yeah.
But I think if we're looking to build golfers, which players that are novice or younger juniors, wouldn't it be nice to create a system where the face doesn't have to flash as much?
Mm.
That would be kind of nice.
Yes.
So let's build that in.
Yeah.
Okay, so if you can imagine, like when I'm holding this ball right here,
sure.
that the shaft would be straight up and down.
Yeah, I'll just kind of
beautiful,
mirror
perfect.
You.
Okay, so if I did this just in the hands, it's not a stable movement at all. And we've talked about this in like other videos,
sure.
like the Orion's Belt video,
mm-hmm.
will help showcase this. But the center of mass should stay in between the elbows for a lot longer period.
Got it.
So to shallow the center of mass over to the right side, like TJ's right side, you can do it in the hands, but it's not that stable.
Understood.
And it won't feel that great. I could also do it in just the arms. Okay. And that one is better, but mm-hmm. still ain't there all the way.
Okay.
Or I could do it ideally just in the ribs. There you go. But now the ribs are what make this whole movement happen. Now look at what happens. Go ahead and do that again. When you do that, watch what the center of mass of the club does. It goes over here,
mm-hmm.
which is what we want. Now this doesn't necessarily look like golf swing yet because we haven't turned. So let's go ahead and set up. Just turn over towards the camera and keep your feet there. Good, now show ribs. Look at what the center of mass just did.
Mm-hmm.
That's beautiful. So now we've moved the center of mass over here based on what the ribs are doing to line up the forces. So now if you turn the chest, the center of mass would get shot out and away. Yep.
Okay.
Exactly. So if we start more in golf posture and swing it to the top, good. Now feel it in the ribs and then shoot it. Ribs, come on. Excellent. Nice, right in my bag. But that's it. Like, if you slow that video down and we put a tracer just on the center of mass of the club, we'd see it go behind you a bit and then out.
Yep.
So shallowing looks all sexy, and this is this term, and there's like a lot of guys out there that will like argue shallowing, and you're more than welcome to. Like, you don't have to shallow it,
mm-hmm.
but what you're seeing, like if somebody doesn't shallow the center of mass of the club, you're gonna definitely see earlier shoulder extension and earlier external rotation of the lead arm, because now what that does is it keeps the center of mass of the club up on top of the plane. So there's shoulder extension, there's external rotation of the lead arm.
Mm-hmm.
So that would just be the arms working down and then eventually working this way. So you can see where the center of mass of the golf club is gonna be compared to if I'm here and feeling ribs and then now out.
That's a cool look, yeah.
Yeah, so now like you can see different pictures, but I'm doing that. Does it leak into the arms and the hands? Sure,
yep.
But the picture is I'm just going left bend, right bend.
Just in the ribs, right?
So if I was just holding the club, like you can see where the center of mass of the club would go,
uh-huh.
where it would go.
Yep.
Right? Cool. So one of our favorite drills is one, and TJ will throw me one here in a second, but to foster this, we're up to the top. And then in the ribs, we're going to try to make this ball go level. See how my trail elbow
yeah.
is underneath the lead elbow?
Got it.
So if I turned and tossed it to the wall, that would be still the shootout
mm-hmm.
from the ball. So go ahead and show a couple of those.
Go kind of ribs.
Boom.
Till I'm
and then
about
if you
level
turn
here.
And just tossed it out. There you go. And notice, no spin still.
Got it.
So we're up. Boom.
Oh, that's good. Okay. Same thing, maybe a little quicker.
Sure. Excellent. And you could even drop with this if you want to go, whoa.
So same feel in the ribs, you could add a little drop in the pelvis as well.
Yep. So I think what would be really cool is if we show that same feel with a golf club, what the center of mass of the club is going to look like as you're doing that. Beautiful. So that buys you time too, because this lead elbow is going skyward to do that. There you go. And this is a common misconception too, that this lead arm needs to stay on the torso. It doesn't need to at all. This can like really separate.
Yeah, yeah.
So the towel drill, I'm not a huge fan of. We could also show like Victor Hovland at like P5.5 looks like this. Mm-hmm. That towel would be completely out of there.
Gone, yeah.
Super internally rotated.
Sure.
Now, other guys, do they look like this?
Yeah, they
sure
do.
Sure, they do.
Yeah.
But they're not my favorite movers.
Fair enough.
Right?
Okay.
Because again, what that action does is it makes the center of mass of the golf club go behind me. Hmm. So if I were to turn, it shoots it out. It's a super stable, like low rate of rotation action.
That's cool.
Okay, let's hit one more. So this one's going to feel like what you're doing is like a combo of both exercises. So one of the exercises is ball is falling, so you're dropping with it. But I want you to feel that weightlessness,
okay,
if you will, along with, we'll call this kill shot. Turn it sideways, baby.
So just weightless kill shot.
A weightless kill shot. There's our new phrase. I mean, it don't get no better.
Yeah,
but if you slow that down, again, the golf club center of mass is up here and it falls behind. It doesn't need to go drastically. For some, it will.
No, it doesn't really go drastically.
It doesn't have to, right? Especially the more neutral you are up in here. So mm-hmm. It's not like, you know, Matt Wolf has some crazier stuff going on. Mm-hmm. Even Javi, he's like his center of mass goes over there because of the structure of his arms. For most that's neutral, it's going to look more in there.
So for most, when they feel this, they're just going to see a slight...
Yeah, it just kind of falls. Like the club head goes back there just a little bit, and then turn, you shoot.
And again, it's mostly a testament, like you're not doing that actively. Like,
yep, exactly.
In the hands and wrists, at least.
Exactly. So I think a couple of really cool things, like three, just off the top of my head with the medicine ball exercises, is it can help pair up and marry the ribs and the arms, because again, there's some amount of shoulder flexion to get the arms and the golf club working up, right? Along with rib rotation, torso rotation, and how they marry to the top. Along with, that'd be number one. Number two would be the dropping action in the pelvis will marry with the weightlessness of the ball as it's falling.
Got it.
Right, so that's a good mental representation. So we don't need to get up here and like slowly drop. Mm-hmm. Positional based again, we want it to be weightless.
So that's a free.
Yep,
drop.
And we'll just use Kendall's term. That's gathering.
Gathering the golf club.
Gathering the golf club, exactly. And the other piece is the rib action. So we're feeling shallowing. The center of mass goes behind you because of what the ribs are doing, which really is the spine, it's side bend. There you go, to get the golf club working back behind you. Exactly, so now you have like all these really cool dynamic feels athletically that you can play golf with, which at the end of the day is like, wouldn't it be nice to go to the gym, do some med ball tosses, go straight out to the golf course, and you're like, man, I feel good.
Yeah.
Right? And you're going to have to play with this a little bit because everybody feels a little bit differently, but based on how you're moving from a proximal standpoint, it will help the golf club distal move in split in space better and create proper forces, which really we relate back to rhythm and tempo as athletes. Mm-hmm. Just feel better and move better so that you hit better shots when you go play golf.
It's the whole goal, right?
Yes. So check out Kendall's book. It's freaking awesome. Again, TJ, I'll put it up on the YouTube here.
Sweet.
Written again by Kendall Yonomoto, one of my best friends and mentors growing up and going through the professional ranks back in the day. Questions? Comment below. We'll answer.
Tweet.
Boom.
Boom.